All right, this is how to prepare a buffer at a targeted pH indirectly by adding acid. How many mL of 1.0 molar HCl must be added to 2.0 liter of 0.15 molar potassium dihydrogen phosphate to prepare a pH equal 2.00 buffer? Okay, well, let's think about what we've got in solution. Potassium dihydrogen phosphate, when you put it in solution, actually gives us potassium and dihydrogen phosphate. Okay, so that's one thing in solution. As you well know, HCl in solution is really reacting with water to give us hydronium and chloride. Okay, so the two things that I'm probably interested in determining the reaction of them, would be the dihydrogen phosphate and the hydronium. So let me write those in a reaction. Okay, H2PO4 minus aqueous plus hydronium, which also starts out aqueous, makes some amount of, let's see, I need to protonate the H2PO4 1 minus. This is actually my base, and this is my acid. So I need to protonate the H2PO4 minus, so that'd be H3PO4. And my acid loses a proton, so that would leave me with H2O. Alright, there's that part of it. Now, let me look at my starting amounts. I have 2 liters of 0.15 molar. So initially, I have 0.300 moles of dihydrogen phosphate. And the question asks, how much HCl do I need to add? Well, if you remember your equilibrium problems, the amount you want to add, you actually need to put on the initial line. That's what I want to figure out. And initially, I don't have any H3PO4. Now, at this point, some of you might be tempted to say, well, this is an equilibrium, and I have to subtract X and add X here to figure out how much I need. But honestly, this is a very extensive reaction. This is one that actually slams all the way to the right, so we can treat that as a limiting reactant problem. Now, how would I know that? Well, remember how to figure out the equilibrium constant of these reactions, okay? The K, I'm just going to write it over here, has to be equal to the Ka of the reacting acid, that'd be hydronium, over the Ka of the produced acid, that'd be H3PO4. If you look these values up, Ka of hydronium is 1, and Ka of H3PO4 is 7.5 times 10 to the minus 3. So 7.5 e to the minus 3 divided into 1 gives us an equilibrium constant of 133. This is a pretty darn good reaction, and it's going to slam to the right, okay? So I'm going to treat this like a limiting reagent problem. I'm going to subtract all of my hydronium, and an equal molar amount will I lose from the dihydrogen phosphate, and I will make that same amount plus X of the phosphoric acid. Okay, so in the final row, this will be 0.300 minus X, 0, and X. Okay, now to break out the Henderson-Hasselbalch. Okay, the pH is equal to the pKa plus the log of base divided by acid. Okay, my target pH is 2.00. My pKa has to be the right value between my base and my acid. So I am going to use the 2.12. because that is phosphoric acid losing a proton. That's the right Ka for that particular reaction. Plus log. Now, how did I represent my base? I represented it as 0.300 minus X, and I represented my acid form, H3PO4, as X. All right, well, we'll just solve some math here. So 10 to the minus 0.12, I'm going to bring that over, and then take it to the 10th power, is equal to 10 to this log, so that gets rid of the log, 0.300 minus X over X. Okay, let's see. 10 raised to the negative 0.12 is 0.7586. Okay, so I'm going to multiply this across. So 0.7586X is equal to 0.300 minus X, or 1.7586X is equal to 0.300. So my X is equal to 0.1706. Now, once again, if you go and type this into WebAssign, you're going to get, it's not right. Because this is simply representing the amount in the reaction table. So this is telling us the moles of acid that we have to add. What were we asked for? We were asked for mils. Oh, okay. Fine. 0.1706 moles of hydronium, and there is 1.0 mole of hydronium for every 1 liter of solution. So, oh, that's useful. So it's divided by 1. So 0.1706 liters, which should be equal to 170.6 mLs. Boy, that's a lot of material. And I guess worrying about sig figs, that would be 1.7 times 10 to the second milliliters that I need to add.